All right, now we need to think about where our rib cage and our ab muscles are. So as we look around here, we're going to have basically an area across the top of the abs that's going to transition down and around into the rib cage. So we're going to start thinking about where that is. So we'll smooth that back in. But I want a little bit of definition there. So I don't want to get rid of this curve too much. I just wanted to transition back into the mass up here. All right, so back to our sculpt brush, and then we can just carve in slightly under that. All right, so now that we have at least a little bit of a curve there, we can start to figure out how this is all going to work together. All right, now I'm going to go back to my sculpt brush and then with a smaller brush, holding down the control key, I'm going to make a line down the center. So we have that center definition for the ab muscles are going to be. Now, typically, the sixth or third, I guess, depending on how you think about it, ab muscle is going to be relatively low on the abdomen. Bring that down there. One right in here. And then our last one right up here. Again, we don't have a ton of detail in our mesh, so we can't get incredibly detailed with what we're sculpting right here. But we do at least have enough detail that we can start defining where those shapes are. We don't have to worry too much about it, but right in here is where our belly button's going to be. All right, so that's roughed in just fine. We can definitely tell where those ab muscles are going to go now. In this area, we're going to end up having our serratus muscles. So we can rough in something right now that's going to look at least like a start to those muscles. That's not too bad. The external obliques. Soften that back in. Again, we don't have a lot of ability to get real definition. But we do want to think about how that flows across the body. Come around to the back, we can define this a little bit more. So we're going to come up and we're going to think about actually the edge of the trapezius muscle up here that comes up and across the shoulder. So we'll use control and carve in a little bit at the bottom edge of that trap. Soften that back in. The lat muscle comes around this way. So we can bulk it up on this edge a little bit and then kind of smooth its transition back into the back. And right in here, we actually have a little divot where there is no large muscle mass. It's kind of almost where some muscles attach to the scapula right in there. That looks pretty good, actually. All right, now if we go back here, we're actually gonna carve a little bit out of this muscle. And really, in this area, there's a large band of tendon where it attaches. So then we'll smooth that back in. All right, that's pretty good. From here, we're going to be moving on to the leg muscles.